सभापति महोदय, मैं आपके प्रति आभार व्यक्त करता हूं कि आपने मुझे ऑक्यूपेशनल सेफ्टी हेल्थ एंड वर्किंग कंडीशंस बिल 2019, इंडस्ट्रियल रिलेशन बिल 2019 और सोशल सिक्योरिटी बिल 2019 पर बोलने का मौका दिया। चेयरमैन सर, देयर इज अ फेमस सेइंग एंड वी नीड टू नो इट्स एलैबोरेट मीनिंग एंड जेनेसिस एंड इट्स एप्लीकेबिलिटी टुडे एज वी डिस्कस द पासिंग ऑफ दिस बिल्स और कोड्स एज वी मे से। United we stand, divided we fall. It's a phrase used in many different kinds of mottos, most often to inspire unity and collaboration. Its core concept lies in the collectivist notion that if individual members of a certain group with binding ideals, such as a coalition, confederation, or alliance, work on their own instead of as a team, they are each doomed to fail and will all be defeated. The phrase is also often referred to with only the words "United we stand." The phrase has been attributed to the ancient Greek storyteller Aesop, both directly in his fable "The Four Oxen and the Lion" and indirectly in the "Bundle of Sticks." Every portion of the Indian growth pyramid—worker, employer, investor, consumer—has to work unitedly to build a new India, ek Atmanirbhar Bharat. महोदय, ऑक्यूपेशनल सेफ्टी हेल्थ एंड वर्किंग कंडीशंस बिल 2019, इंडस्ट्रियल रिलेशन बिल 2019 और सोशल सिक्योरिटी बिल 2019, ये वर्ष 2019 में पहली बार इंट्रोड्यूस हुए थे, जैसा माननीय मंत्री जी ने भी कहा, और इंट्रोडक्शन के बाद पार्लियामेंट्री स्टैंडिंग कमेटी ऑन लेबर को रेफर किए गए। पार्लियामेंट्री स्टैंडिंग कमेटी ने तीनों लेबर कोड के संबंध में पूरी विस्तृत चर्चा की और हर एक स्टेक होल्डर से करीब 233 अनुशंसाएं लेबर मंत्रालय को दी। लेबर मंत्रालय द्वारा फिर से सभी स्टेक होल्डर से फिर से परामर्श किया और उसके बाद उनमें से करीब 174 अनुशंसाएं मान ली और इन अनुशंसाओं के कारण बहुत सारे मूलभूत परिवर्तन हुए हैं और लेबर कोड्स में किए गए भी। इस तरह सोशल सिक्योरिटी कोड में प्रियम्बल में भी परिवर्तन किया गया है, तभी बहुत विस्तृत वर्किंग क्लास इसके दायरे में आ रहे हैं, क्योंकि ऐसा भी प्रोविजन है कि ऑक्यूपेशनल सेफ्टी एक्ट में जहां माइनिंग एंड डॉक एक्टिविटी में एक वर्कर है तो वो भी कवर्ड, दायरा बहुत विस्तृत है इसके अंतर्गत। चेयरमैन सर, एज द मिनिस्टर रेफर्ड, ऑल दीज बिल्स डील विथ अराउंड 50 करोड़ वर्कर्स ऑफ टूडे, but the ramification is not just confined to today, but the multitude of workers of tomorrow has also been dealt with through these progressive labor reforms. Worker is the soul of India, sir. The workers and employers are two pillars of our national economy. Workers are the dominant partners in the industrial undertakings, and without their cooperation, effort, discipline, integrity and character, the industry cannot survive. It cannot be denied that labor has a vital role in increasing productivity, and the government has to create conditions in which workers can make their maximum contribution towards these objectives. The central government, under the able leadership of Prime Minister Modi, is committed towards welfare of workers. In this connection, the social and economic upliftment of the labor is very important for securing industrial peace and economic growth. And it is about capacitating a human resource to perform so as to compete. It is the duty of the government to provide structure, facilitate and regulate policies and laws, keeping in mind these objectives. Mahoday, mool dhye ke tahat agar hum dekhen, to jo soch mein hai, wo hai kya? Soch mein hai sabka saath, sabka vikas aur sabka vishwas lekar, jaan bhi और जहां भी ये लेबर लेजिस्लेशंस लाया गया है एक आत्मनिर्भर भारत के निर्माण के लिए। अभी तक ऑक्यूपेशनल सेफ्टी हेल्थ एंड वर्किंग कंडीशंस कोड की बात अगर करें तो 13 में से 9 लेबर एक्ट्स के लिए सेपरेट रिटर्न्स फाइल करना होता था, 13 में से 9 के लिए सेपरेट रिटर्न्स, 58 रजिस्टर्स जो स्टेट द्वारा निर्धारित हो वो अलग मेंटेन करना होता था। 13 लेबर एक्ट के तहत आप कंबर्सम कितना था इसकी आप कल्पना कर सकते हैं। अब कहिए लेबर एंड इंडस्ट्रियल डिस्प्यूट होगा या नहीं होगा? हो ही रहा है, सब परेशान है, कर्मचारी भी, एम्प्लॉयर भी। और व्हाट इज द न्यू कोड प्रपोज? इट प्रपोजेज वन सिंगल रिटर्न, वन सिंगल रिटर्न, हेंस कंसोलिडेटिंग कंप्लायंस बर्डन एंड डेटाबेस, प्रमोटिंग ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस। The new codes makes things very simple and unifies everything together. Many interpretational ambiguities have been eliminated, along with substantive reforms in dispute resolution procedures, by providing for a single license mechanism. By simplifying the multiple laws only into three codes, the country, under the guidance of Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji, is moving towards one code, one nation. Or we could also say one country, one license. Sir, I would like to come on the code on occupational safety, health and working conditions code. Sir, the code has amalgamated and rationalized the provisions of 13 labor enactments, factories, dock workers, building and other construction workers, plantation labor, contract labor, interstate migrant workers, working journalists, and other newspaper employees as well, motor transport workers, sales promotion employees, bidi and cigar workers, cine workers, cinema theater workers, the industrial relation code. The occupational safety code envisages safety standards for different sectors, focusing primarily on health and working conditions, ventilation, drinking water, hours of work, overtime hours, leave, holiday, etc. Welfare provisions, canteen, creche,
Mr. Thakur,
first aid.
Please mask take kar lijiye, mask pehen lijiye.
Duties of employees, manufacturer, etc. Registration of establishments, including deemed registration, license for contract workers, factories, bidi and cigar workers. This code facilitates the ease of doing business and ensures minimization of registration and compliances. It also ensures digitization of compliances along with streamlining ambiguities and duplication of information. The code expands ambit to cover a large set of establishments and enhances the coverage of the safety and health provision to all sets of establishments, including the service sector. So there's a very big problem in the labor-industrial relationship, that of Inspector Raj. This code proposes delinking of inspectors from certain specific geographical regions. The code envisages the concept of the inspector come facilitator may also be assigned duty outside his jurisdiction by the appropriate government through a randomized computer system. The inspector may also seek information and documents online from establishments. This will encourage transparency and would discourage formation of nexus between inspector and employer of a particular region. The code provides for special provisions for interstate migrant laborers and streamlines management of contract labor. Chairman sir, 14 tarikh ko satr aarambh hone ke pehle मैं बिहार में लगातार विभिन्न पंचायतों में प्रवास किया, वर्चुअल नहीं, रियल, और बातचीत में ऐसा विश्वास और आस्था देखा प्रधानमंत्री जी के प्रति, ग्रामीणों का, श्रमिक भाइयों का, जो वापस आए, जो पूरा दुनिया ने देखा, कि उनका वर्णन पूरा करना आज मुश्किल है। जितने केंद्र के निर्णय उनके पास पहुंचा उसका संतोष जो उन्होंने व्यक्त किया वह अद्भुत रहा। चाहे रेल से उनको पहुंचाना हो, गैस की उपलब्धता हो, गरीब कल्याण योजना के तहत अनाज उपलब्धता हो, वन नेशन वन राशन कार्ड हो, इट वाज अ वेरी ओवरवेलमिंग फीलिंग ऑफ ऑल द एफर्ट्स दैट वाज टेकन बाय द इनिशिएटिव्स टेकन बाय द ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर। Sir, it is important to note, based on what the whole country witnessed with regard to migrant laborers, that Chapter 11 of the Code envisages specific provisions which provide for licensing of contractors and maintenance of records of migrant workers. The provisions under this chapter also encapsulate the concept of elimination of discrimination in employment or occupation and the basic idea of United India. This would enhance the coverage of the interstate migrant workers for the purpose of benefits like housing, education, etc., and encompasses the government's ideology of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vishwas. Gender equality and special provision to extend the compensation to grandparents in case of demise of a worker have also been incorporated in the code as well. Sir, Mahila Sashaktikaran pe bahut focus is pe raha hai. The chapter 10 of the code encompasses special provision relating to employment of women. The code promotes gender equality and is in tune with demands from the various forums. The point to be noted here is that, sir, women are permitted to work beyond 7 p.m. and before 6 a.m., subject to the safety, holidays, working hours, or any other condition as prescribed by appropriate government, subject to taking consent from the woman worker. At present, women are prohibited in 9 for mines, factories, plantation, bidi and cigar. The explicit consent of the women worker is an essential prerequisite for such permissions. This code will play a very pivotal role in reshaping the economic structure of the society in the post-COVID era, sir. For the planned, progressive and purposeful development of the society, proper implementation of a beneficial legislation regulating employer-employee relationship is a condition precedent. With your permission, sir, I would like to throw light on the other bill of the Industrial Relation Code, also referred as IR Code, sir. Sir, the Industrial Relation Code 2019 intends to subsume the three industrial acts, the Industrial Disputes Act 1947, the Trade Union Act 1926, the Industrial Employment Standing Orders Act 1946, and simplifies a lot of interpretational issues faced in the archaic acts dealing with industrial disputes and facilitating a healthy trust-based mechanism of handling industrial relations and disputes. Sir, the codification of the above labor laws by consolidation of relevant provisions at one place aims at facilitating the implementation and removing the multiplicity of definitions and authorities without compromising the available safeguard. The code also proposes to bring transparency and accountability in the enforcement of labor laws, which would lead to better industrial relations and thus greater productivity. The code provides for a revamp of adjudication procedures. Many unnecessary and archaic adjudication procedures in the erstwhile acts have been streamlined in the code, thus facilitating early resolution of industrial disputes. It also provides for statutory benefits like social security, wages, etc., at par with the regular employees to fixed-term employees. So this is a very significant step. There are lots of key takeaways, but concising it, I would like to show some light on the legal consolidation and the removal of ambiguities. The industry's definition, what has been that? Sir, the clause 2M of the new code, encapsulates the amended definition of the term industry. Industry means any systematic activity carried on by cooperation between employer and his workers, whether such workers are employed by such employer directly or by or through any agency, including a contractor, for the production, supply or distribution of goods or services with a view to satisfy human wants or wishes, not being wants or wishes which are merely spiritual or religious in nature. However, It does not include institutions owned or wholly or substantially engaged in any charitable, social or philanthropic services, sovereign functions, domestic services, and any other activity as may be not notified by the central government. This definition is elaborative and includes all the components of the triple test and also removes all the interpretational ambiguities in the erstwhile definition of the term industry as defined under the Industrial Disputes Act of 1947. With regard to the definition of strikes, sir, the inclusion of the concept of mass casual leave, the definition of strike is being amended to include mass casual leave also within its ambit, clause 2ZF in the code. It's important for India, sir. It's very important for India to get out of the war, as I speak, that we are stuck in. It's what the youthful progressive India wants, sir. Sir, on the judicial reforms in the IR code, it's very important to note a few things. Various substantive adjudication procedures have been streamlined in the code, sir. Presently, about 23,000 cases are pending in 22 central government industrial tribunals, also referred as CGITs, which include about 5,000 cases which were transferred after the merger of two employees' provident fund appellate tribunals with CGITs. Now, sir, two members industrial tribunal has been proposed, with second member from the administrative side in place of a single member labor court or industrial tribunal at present. It is observed that cases remain pending for years and years due to vacancies in the industrial tribunals arising out of leave, resignation, transfer, death of the single member, leading to delay in disposal of cases and having adverse impact on the labor welfare. It is proposed a bench of the tribunal may consist of two members, that is judicial and administrative member. A bench consisting of two members, judicial and administrative, shall adjudicate cases relating to discharge, dismissal, retrenchment, closure, strike, application and interpretation of standing orders. The remaining cases can be decided either by a judicial member or an administrative member of the tribunal in the manner as prescribed. This flexibility has been provided to ensure speedy disposal of cases by the tribunal, sir. So there's a huge social impact, but if I mention a few, the provision that a fixed-term employee will get all statutory benefits like social security, wages, etc., at par with the regular employees who are doing work of same or similar nature has also been inserted, sir. This will enhance trust between the employer and employees and will enhance productivity and enhance credibility for sure. A clause has been added that termination of the service of a worker as a result of completion of tenure of fixed-term employment would not be retrenchment. This clarity will reduce the huge problem of interpretation issues and litigation between employee and employer, sir. A very novel and a new concept has been introduced, sir, a reskilling fund. A reskilling fund is a very new initiative for the training of retrenched employees, which is proposed from the contribution to be made by an industrial establishment for an amount equal to 15 days' wages or such other days as may be notified by the central government, and to this fund for every worker retrenched. The retrenched employee would be paid 15 days' wages from the fund within 45 days from the date of retrenchment. This will ensure skill enhancement, capacity building for the retrenched employee and enhance his or her future employability. Sir, with your due permission, I would like to throw some light on the code on social security. So this code replaces 9 laws related to social security. This includes the Employees Provident Fund Act 1952, the Maternity Benefit Act 1961, and the Unorganized Workers Social Security Act 2008. But it consolidates the whole social security framework. Establishments above a certain specified size have to provide benefits such as provident fund and insurance. These are mandatory for employees above a wage level which will be notified. The code also proposes to extend the coverage of employees' state insurance to all establishments employing 10 or more employees and to the employees working in establishment with less than 10 employees on voluntary basis, and also to plantation related industry like tea, coffee, spices, etc. As regards other workers, the government aims to frame social security schemes including gig workers and workers in unorganized sectors. So every day in our daily lives, we are seeing delivery boys and girls of, say, Zomato, Swiggy, Amazon, Flipkart, the Ola Uber drivers. Randomly, we call through the app any time of the day, sir, and it's delivered, or your vehicle is at your doorstep, sir. Even this class has been covered, which was untouched so far, sir. It's a very innovative initiative, sir. Under this code, the government will notify various social security schemes for workers. The code has proposed the establishment of several bodies to administer the schemes. These include a central board to administer the Provident Fund schemes, national and state level social security boards to administer schemes for unorganized workers. The code envisages to include a vast segment of workers with the ambit of social security schemes, sir. With such a comprehensive and detailed decision taken, sir, we could say that the country is moving towards one code, one nation. And it is important, sir. It is important to eliminate dualities and ambiguities from existing labor laws so that industry is in a better position to leverage the full potential of the market in the country without any fear. The labor laws should foster an enabling environment so far as employment practices are concerned. Sooner we overcome compliance mindset, better is our chances of enhancing global competitiveness in manufacturing as well as service sector. But very importantly, sir, it's a time for a reset under the new COVID era, sir. It is the correct time that the central government has focused on coalescing all the existing labor laws into one unified piece of legislation with specific sections covering labor management relations, wages, social security, safety at workplace, welfare provisions, terms and conditions of employment, recognition of trade unions, provisions regarding collective bargaining, and above all, enforcement of international labor standards. Such a legislative marvel will indeed be a model for state government, sir. Sir, without an iota of doubt, one can say, sir, these are initiatives towards an Atmanirbhar Bharat in absolute terms, sir. Moreover, such a legislation will be effective only if it is universally applicable, covering all the workers in formal as well as informal sectors. And for sure, the government aims to seek the same as per provisions of these three codes, including the earlier Code of Wages, which stands implemented, as the Honorable Minister had referred also in his speech, sir. It is indeed a necessity to develop a consensus on labor issues rather than continuing with an ad hoc approach to amend a few provisions of labor laws just to please the industries. The government has duly attempted to revamp the existing enactments affecting employer-employee relationship. Sir, the government is committed to walk the path towards a new India with more jobs and greater economic growth. The new codes will surely enhance labor trust, industry, investor, and propel productivity and economic growth. And in the end, I would like to say that, sir, the world order and alliances is to change post-corona. It's a hard fact that we should know that we are going to see, sir. The battle to excel shall begin globally, absolutely afresh, sir. जिसको हिंदी में हम कहते हैं कि सर स्लेट साफ हो रहा है और नए आरंभ के लिए. इट इज गोइंग टू बी अ रेस टू कॉर्नर स्पेस इन द न्यू वर्ल्ड डेवलपमेंट स्टोरी सर. एंड द न्यू इनिशिएटिव्स और लेबर रिफॉर्म्स इज गेयरिंग द यूथफुल इंडिया टू बी नॉट जस्ट अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस रेस बट टू विन द रेस विद अ ह्यूमेन अप्रोच. सबके साथ होगा सबका विकास, लेकर सबका विश्वास और बनेगा आत्मनिर्भर भारत. यह राजनीति से ऊपर होना चाहिए सर, और यह देश के निर्णायक नौजवान को तय करना है काम और उत्थान के बनाम क्या, निंदा और बंदी की राजनीति में फंसना है या नहीं फंसना है, क्योंकि यह भारत के नए युग का भविष्य वह उसका निर्धारण करेगा. थैंक यू सर, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.